Hi, this is Vahid, the IELTS expert at Forbest Academy. IELTS candidates hold some views about the test that can hugely affect the way they approach the tasks and, of course, their performance on the test. In fact, what motivated me to make this video was my recent adventure with one of my students that eventually enabled him to increase his score from 6 on his first attempt to a beautiful 7 on his second attempt. We achieved this by simply examining his views on the test as well as the strategies he employed. Not surprisingly, there were some fallacies that inhibited his progress. So let's check some of these misconceptions. Number one, the body paragraphs are more important than the introduction. This myth has to do with the writing section. A word of caution here. Do not underestimate the impact of a good first impression. Every essay starts with the intro, which carries your thesis statement. If your intro is too general and it does not address the central issue, or you fail to paraphrase the question, you will lose marks. Intros characterized by grammatical mistakes are highly likely to shape examiners' opinion of your final score, as most examiners only spend 2 minutes on the assessment of each task. Myth number two. Only native speakers of English get 9 on the test. If you get a band score of 9, you're an expert user of English. So even if you're a native speaker of English, your score may not be 9, especially when it comes to the writing section of the test. Truth is, I've seen many of my friends who happen to be native speakers never amounting to anything more than 7, as they're bad spellers or simply aren't sophisticated with essay writing. Number three, spelling mistakes aren't important. Spelling mistakes can kill your score. IELTS listening scores are based on correct answers. To get 1 point, you need to spell the words you hear correctly. In fact, this is what makes the IELTS listening section more difficult than that of the TOEFL or CELPIP. So you should be careful with the use of hyphens in the case of compound nouns and adjectives, plural S endings, and Latin words in English. Any spelling mistake takes its toll on your overall score. We have provided a list of commonly misspelled words, as well as rules of spelling English words on our website that can help you improve your spelling and conquer the test. Myth number four, writing task 2 determines your score. Writing task 2 is given more weight, and it accounts for nearly 70% of your overall score. But truth is, it is impossible to get a high band score if you do not do a good job on task 1. If you continually score below 7, it is probably because you focus too much on task 2 at the cost of task 1. Examiners assess each writing task independently, giving more weight to task 2 in marking than task 1. At the end, writing scores along with other scores from each module of the test are averaged and rounded to produce an overall band score. Number 5. Simplicity is power. Yes, simplicity is power, but not in the context of the IELTS test. Your essays are marked based on the assessment criteria that emphasize grammatical range and lexical resources. An error-free essay that uses simple structures and does not feature impressive vocabulary only ends in an average score. If you plan to get a high band score, you should use advanced vocabulary, collocations, and a wide range of complex sentences. I'd like to end this section with a quote from Dr. Wayne Dyer. When you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change. Thank you for watching this video, and please remember to subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.